Speak student.
Compound interest, a la Shmoop. Question, how do you become a billionaire?
Builds hotels on Boardwalk and Park Place.
Answer, this guy, the richest man in America for a long time, said, live to be 300. If you save money for long enough, you get there.
Now this is the life.
If you save 10 grand a year, you get to a billion in a billion divided by 10,000 years or 100,000 years. That's a little beyond the current average life expectancy.
How long have I got, Doc?
Doesn't look good. Only about 48,000 years.
So there's got to be a better way. Yeah, compound interest.
Very interesting.
That is, you invest your money. Stock market, bonds, private equity, venture capital, whatever. And you make some kind of return. Put in a dollar today and get $2 back in 5 years and you've made about 20% a year.
I need to fire my financial advisor.
So if you compound your interest, you start with a new amount each year. Let's see how that works in real life. Over the last 100 years or so, the stock market has compounded with dividends reinvested and forgetting taxes at about 10% a year. Take the interest rate at which you are compounding and divide it into 72. Remove the decimals, and the answer is the number of years it takes for your investment to double. That is, if you compound at 10% a year, it takes 7.2 years for the investment to double. Let's start with 10 grand. You've mown a lot of lawns to get there and you invest it. After 1 year of compound interest, it's worth 11 grand. Yep, you made $1,000 doing nothing. The coolest element in compound interest is that now you start out the year with 11 grand. And you get to compound it, blam. And after one more year, it's now worth $12,100. Let's think about the same problem, but this time we'll use equations. Remember, we start with $10,000 and compound at 10% per year for 1 year. When we work out the math, we see that $10,000 times 1.1 equals $11,000. Note that after the first year, you made exactly a grand. But now, since you started with a higher base of 11 grand instead of 10 grand, you get to compound off of a higher number. And in year two, you've made $100 more for the privilege. Taking a closer look, we can see that we're building a thing called the equation for compound interest. A is the ending amount, P is the starting amount, R is the interest rate, N is the number of times compounding happens per year, and T is the number of years your money is being compounded. For now, we'll assume compounding happens once a year, so N just equals 1. And the process continues. So let's say you did nothing but sit on your big fat duff the rest of your life other than save that 10 grand when you were 25. Thanks again for mentioning us in your will, Grandpa Warbucks.
This is better than the view.
Here's what that 10 grand looks like compounded over an expected 60 remaining years of your life. Here we are at year 8. We've seen our 10 grand blossom into over 21 grand. It's certainly moving in the right direction. In fact, we've more than doubled our original investment. But it's not quite enough to pack it all in and retire to the Caymans.
What do you mean this card's no good?
Well, sheesh, it's only been a decade and we're only sitting on $20,000. Is this compound interest thing really all it's cracked up to be?
It's not as comfortable as you think.
Well, let's move down the road. Year 15, we've doubled our money yet again, nearly 42 grand in the bank. Assuming that by this point we don't owe large sums of money to anyone who is threatening to break our legs.
Big Tony doesn't like to be displeased.
Year 22, doubled again to over 81,000. Year 29, nearly 160,000. Up and up we go. Year 36, year 43, year 50, year 57. Until finally, wow, check out year 60. Over $3 million, which 60 years from now might be almost enough to fill up your gas tank or buy you a carton of milk. So we start with $10,000 and compound at 10% per year for 60 years. Okay, sure, 60 years is a long time from now, but think how nice it's going to be to have all those millions just sitting there waiting for you to get old and retire.
Well, aren't you a sight for sore eyes?
And this example only demonstrates what happens if you invest $10,000 in your entire lifetime. If you start with a larger investment or contribute additional funds along the way, it should be easy to see how one might quite conceivably become a billionaire if they play their cards right.
Are pocket aces any good?
Speaking of gambling, your other option is to sit down at the roulette table, put your life savings on black, and let it ride about 20 or 30 times. Let us know how that goes.
What do you mean this card's no good?